Internet addiction. Use is up 900% plus. Now what? I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. Let's break it down together. In this video, we're going to talk about how much the internet is being used, which will be no shock to you, but it's still shocking to hear the numbers. Then we will talk about what internet use is doing to your brain. And lastly, we'll talk about what you can do about it. Okay, so first of all, there's a study and you can click the link below and go through to the blog post on my website, which will give you more information about the studies I'm going to talk about in this video with some graphics if you want to check it out for yourself. But there's a study that looked at internet use among adolescents. And actually the study was from 2010 to 2016. So it's a little bit older now. So I imagine the percentages are in the thousands, more than 900% now, since the study is a little bit dated. And with the advent of social media and people being on so much more, it's gotta be even higher. But what the numbers show is that at that time, 100% of adolescents between 12 and 18 use the internet daily. More than 80% use the internet on the go. 60% consider the internet and using it to be indispensable. And exactly 0% considered abstinence an option, which means none of those adolescents planned on not using the internet ever again. So we know the internet is here to stay, and we know that everybody's using it all of the time. But what you might not know is that internet use is a super normal stimulus, and that super normal stimulus exists on a continuum. So what I mean is that super normal means more than you can find in nature. It gives your brain a ton of dopamine. Dopamine is the pleasure-seeking neurotransmitter. It makes your brain feel good. So unfortunately, what it does is it links your brain to go back more and more and more for the internet. And what I mean by supernormal stimulus on a continuum is that there's some ways we use the internet that will get you going back for more, and then others will do that even more, like social media, like explicit content, like gaming. Those are much higher supernormal stimuli. They get you hooked faster and harder, like that, unfortunately. So when you continue to go back to use the internet daily with no plans of stopping, what happens is eventually with use, it increases the use of theta, slow brain speed in your brain. It slows your brain down. And we know this from a study that looked at EEG, electroencephalogram, of people who were addicted to the internet, who use the internet a lot. So with more internet use comes more damage to your brain, and more it will show up in your life in terms of your physical and your mental health. Don't believe me? Go to the blog post and check out the studies. They're mind-blowing. So what happens is when you keep going into the screen, you're giving your brain the dopamine that it wants, and you're feeding this brain pattern that wants to feel good, but it leaves your brain wired and tired. And unfortunately, it slows your brain down, too much theta. And what we also know is that there's a low power in the brain from using the internet. So it powers your brain down. You're not able to think as well as you would be able to if you didn't go back into the internet over and over. And so that shows up as low magnitude or not enough of low beta, optimal processing speed in the middle for calm focus, for thinking. Now, if gaming's an issue, or if you know someone who games, which I know a lot of them, and I'm, as the mom of six kids, I'm always trying to reduce the amount of gaming that's happening in my home, hopefully successfully. But if you are hooked on internet gaming, we also know from the science that it increases delta production in your brain. Delta is extra slow brain speed. It's sleep mode, and that's at baseline. So what that means is when you're not gaming and you're out in the world, your brain's falling asleep and it's using sleep mode. Clearly, that's not the best way to think. Thinking mode is in the middle. not out in the extremes of extra slow and slow or extra fast anxiety. That's what I call the pendulum effect. We want to bring your brain into the middle for optimal speed and keep you out of this pendulum that creates anxiety, overwhelm, fatigue, and disconnect from the real world. Okay, that is what internet addiction and especially gaming or explicit content does to your brain. Now, what to do about it? Well, clearly, balancing your screen time or balancing screen time for your beautiful children, like I do, because you're their frontal lobe, executive function, balanced screen time is really, really important. And a rule of thumb is be out in the real world, IRL, 2 times as much as you are in the screen. That is a really good rule of thumb. Another thing is that if you want to see how your brain is performing, if you fear or if you have a concern that your brain has been impacted by internet use, especially explicit content or gaming, you can see how your brain is performing on EEG. Brain mapping is something that me and my team offer. We've been looking at brains that are addicted to the internet for a long time. And in the study that's on the blog post, the authors say EEG should be used more to diagnose the brain pattern associated with internet addiction. I can see that in your brain, and I can share that with you. And what that means is you can see the visual representation of what your internet use is doing to your brain. And what that does is it empowers you to know what you can do to bring that brain pattern back to the middle. And if you go to my website, there's resources there that you can use all by yourself. And if you want to work with professionals, we're there to work with you too. But you can get started at home all by yourself. My goal being here with these videos is to let you know the internet is really bad for your brain. It's damaging your brain if you're using it too much. It's time to get it under control and to bring your brain back to the middle. So find out what your brain is doing so you know what you need to do. Okay, I hope this helps you out. And as always, control your brain or it'll control you.